systems, topic Fourier series, lecture delivered by Indranil Sarkar. Introduction. The Fourier series is a representation for periodic signals. With a Fourier series, a signal is represented as a linear combination of complex sinusoids. The use of complex sinusoids is desirable due to their numerous attractive properties. For example, complex sinusoids are continuous and differentiable. They are also easy to integrate and differentiate. Perhaps most important complex sinusoids are eigenfunctions of LTI system. Continuous type Fourier series. A periodic complex signal X with fundamental period capital T and fundamental frequency omega 0 is equal to 2 pi by capital T can be represented as a linear combination of harmonically related complex sinusoids as xt is equal to summation of k is equal to minus infinity to plus infinity ck e to the power jk omega 0 t. Such a representation is known as the complex exponential form of a continuous time Fourier series, and the ck are called Fourier series coefficients. The above formula of x is often referred to as the Fourier series synthesis equation. The term in the summation for k is equal to capital K and k is equal to minus capital K are called the kth harmonic components and have the fundamental frequency k omega 0. To denote the signal x has the Fourier coefficient sequence ck, we write xt continuous time Fourier series to ck. The periodic signal x with fundamental period capital T and fundamental frequency omega 0 is equal to 2 pi twice pi by t has the Fourier series coefficient ck given by ck is equal to 1 by t. Integral over capital T means total time period xt e to the power minus jk omega 0 t dt, where integration over a time period denotes integration over an arbitrary interval of length capital T, that is one period of x. The above equation for ck is often referred to as the Fourier series analysis equation. Trigonometric forms of a Fourier series. Consider the periodic signal x with the Fourier series coefficient ck. If x is real, then its Fourier series can be rewritten in two other forms, known as the combined trigonometric and trigonometric forms. The combined trigonometric form of a Fourier series has the appearance xt is equal to c0 plus 2 summation of k is equal to 1 to infinity mod of ck cos k omega 0 t plus theta k, where theta k is equal to argument of ck. The trigonometric form of a Fourier series has the appearance xt is equal to c0 plus summation of k is equal to 1 to infinity mod of alpha k cos k omega 0 t plus beta k sin k omega 0 t, where alpha k is equal to 2 real ck and beta k is equal to minus 2 imaginary ck. Note that trigonometric forms contain only real quantities. Convergence of Fourier series. Since a Fourier series can have an infinite number of terms and an infinite sum may or may not converge, we need to consider the issue of convergence. That is, when we claim that a periodic signal xt is equal to the Fourier series, summation of k is equal to minus infinity to plus infinity, ck e to the power jk omega 0 t, is this claim actually correct? Consider a periodic signal x that you wish to represent with the Fourier series, summation of k is equal to minus infinity to plus infinity ck e to the power jk omega 0 t. Let xn denote the Fourier series truncated after the nth harmonic component as given by xnt is equal to summation of k is equal to minus n to plus n ck e to the power jk k omega 0 t. Here we are interested in whether limit n tends to xnt is equal in some senses to xt. The error is approximating xt by xnt is given by ent is equal to xt minus xnt, and the corresponding mean squared error, that is energy of the error, is given by en is equal to 1 by t integration from 0 to t or total time period mod of ent square dt. If limit n tends to ent is equal to 0 for t. If convergence is pointwise and the rate of convergence is the same everywhere, the convergence is said to be uniform. If limit n tends to infinite, En is equal to 0, that is the energy of the error goes to 0, the Fourier series is said to be converged to x in the MSE sense. Pointwise, convergence implies MSE convergence, but the converse is not true. Thus, pointwise convergence is a much stronger condition than MSE convergence. If a periodic signal x is continuous and its Fourier series coefficients ck are absolutely summable, that is, summation of k is equal to minus infinity to infinity, mod of ck less than infinite, then the Fourier series representation of x converges uniformly, that is, pointwise at the same rate everywhere. Since in practice we often encounter signals with discontinuities, as example, a square wave. The above result is of somewhat limited value. Convergence of Fourier series, finite energy case. If a period signal x has finite energy in a single period, that is, integration over a time period, mod of xt square dt less than infinite, the Fourier series converge is in the MSE sense. Since in situation of practice interest, the finite energy condition in the above theorem is typically satisfied, the theorem is usually applicable. It is important to note, however, that MSE convergence, that is equals to zero, does not necessarily imply pointwise convergence, that is, xt bar is equal to xt for all t. Thus, the above convergence theorem does not provide much useful information regarding the value of xt bar at specific values of t. Consequently, the above theorem is typically most useful for simply determining if the Fourier series converges. Convergence of Fourier series, Dirichlet case. The Dirichlet conditions for the periodic signal x are as follows. Number 1, over a single period, x is absolutely integrable. That is, integration over a time period t, mod of xt dt less than infinite. Second, over a single period, x has a finite number of maxima and minima, that is, x is of bounded variation. Third point, over any finite interval, x has a finite number of discontinuities, each of which is finite. Now, if a periodic signal x satisfies the Dirichlet conditions, then, number 1, the Fourier series converges pointwise everywhere to x, except at the point of discontinuity of x. Number 2, at each point t is equal to ta, of discontinuity of x, the Fourier series x bar converges to x bar ta is equal to half x ta minus plus half x ta plus, where x ta minus and x ta plus denotes the value of the signal x on the left side and right side of the discontinuity respectively. Since most signals tend to satisfy the Dirichlet condition and the above convergence result specifies the value of the Fourier series at every point, this result is often very useful in practice. Here is an example of functions violating the Dirichlet conditions. Here we see that there is a separation between the signals. That means it is not continuous signals. That is 1 by t, it ends in 0, fifth started after 0 and ends in 1 and again started after some portion of 1 and so on. In the second signal for sine 2 pi by t also we see that there is some discontinuities between the periods of the signals. Proper Fourier series. XT, continuous time Fourier series, gives the result of AK, and YT for continuous time Fourier series represented as BK. Now, property, time domain, frequency domain. For linearity, alpha XT plus beta YT, in Fourier domain, it becomes alpha AK plus beta BK. Second property, translation. XT minus T0 will be represented in Fourier domain as e to the power minus JK 2 pi by capital T T0 AK. Reflection. In time domain, X minus T will be represented in Fourier domain as A minus K. Conjugation in time domain represented as X star T, which will be in Fourier domain A star minus K. Even symmetry X even in Fourier domain A even. Odd symmetry X odd in time domain and Fourier domain A odd. Real, XT is real and here in Fourier domain AK is equal to A minus K star. Property. Percival's theorem, 1 by t, integration of the time period, mod of xt squared dt is equal to summation of k is equal to minus infinity to plus infinity mod of ak squared. Linearity. Let x and y be two periodic signals with the same period. If xt gives after continuous time Fourier series ak and yt gives after continuous time Fourier series bk, then alpha XT plus beta YT gives after the continuous time Fourier series as alpha AK plus beta BK, where alpha and beta are complex constants. That is, a linear combination of signals produces the same linear combination of their Fourier series coefficients. Time shifting or translation. Let X denotes a periodic signal with period capital T and the corresponding frequency omega 0 is equal to twice pi by capital T. If XT gives continuous time Fourier series to CK, then XT minus T0 of continuous time Fourier series represent e to the power minus JK omega 0 T0 and CK is equal to e to the power minus JK 2 pi by T T0. CK, where T0 is a real constant. In other words, time shifting a periodic signal changes the argument but not magnitude of its Fourier series coefficients. Time reversal or reflection. Let X denotes a periodic signal with periodic capital T and the corresponding frequency omega 0 is equal to twice pi by capital T. If XT after continuous time Fourier series represents CK, then X minus T of continuous time Fourier series will be C minus K. That is, time reversal of a signal results in a time reversal of its Fourier series coefficients. Conjugation. For a T-periodic function X with Fourier series coefficient sequence C, the following properties holds. XT star after continuous time Fourier series produces C minus K star. In other words, conjugating a signal has the effect of time reversing and conjugating the Fourier series coefficient sequences. Even and odd symmetry. For a T-periodic function X with Fourier series coefficient sequence C, the following properties hold. X is even, so the C is even. And in case of X is odd, the C is odd. In other words, the even-odd symmetry property of X and C always match. Real signals. A signal X is real if and only if its Fourier series coefficient sequence C satisfies CK is equal to C minus K star for all K. That is, C has conjugate symmetry. Thus, for a real value signal, the negative indexed Fourier series coefficients are redundant as they are completely determined by the non-negative indexed coefficients. From properties of complex number, one can show that CK is equal to C minus K star is equivalent to mod of CK is equal to C minus K mod and argument CK is equal to minus argument C minus K. That is, mod of CK is even and argument CK is odd. Note that X being real does level. And third,